What's up, Fadr fans? In this video, we're gonna compare making a mashup in Ableton, one of the largest DAWs on the market right now, with Fadr, an AI-powered micro DAW. Now, for those of you who don't know me, I'm Robert. I co-founded Fadr with my friend Gabe about 3 years ago. Now, he's way more experienced in Ableton than I am, but I've picked up a few tricks along the way. Hopefully, you guys will see how much I struggle with this, and I'll be a good analog for a beginner producer. Now, Ableton needs no introduction, but I'm gonna give one anyways. Ableton is a fully featured DAW with no training wheels attached. As you can see on the screen, it's also the most popular DAW, closely followed by Logic, Pro Tools, and FL Studio. Fadr, on the other hand, aims to be the number one place to make a mashup remix regardless of skill level. And it accomplishes this by using multiple AI models for beat and key synchronization, which are fundamental to making a good mashup. In this video, I hope to show you some of the ways that each of these platforms shine and some of their respective drawbacks. So let's get started, and I'll take it right into Ableton.
All right, so here are the two songs I've decided to pick out for the mashup. Love Non Tinti and Calm Down by Selena Gomez. First of all, I'm just gonna run these through Fadr. Now, I know this is for the Ableton part of the comparison, but I'm gonna have to get the vocals anyhow. All right, so I'll just download the vocals here. Now let's do the same for CK. Download. All right, I got Ableton open here. Let's see what's going on. Let's drop in our two audio tracks. All right. Track one, track two. All right, now we're gonna have to figure out what the tempos are. So let's Google that. I know Fadr tells you, but this is the Ableton part of the tutorial. So in order to try to stay as true as possible, let's see. All right, apparently it has a BPM of 107. So let's see, did it get it right? All right, pretty close to 107. 107, boom. And then, oops, I just noticed I have the vocals here. Let me swap it for the instrumental. Swapping it out right now. That's better. All right, so this is at 107. Let's see if we can find Love Non Tinti. Okay, I'm seeing 93. Let's put this up. Yeah, it got it right. Okay. Now we have to get them beat aligned. So let's shrink this down. And let's do the BPM at 107 so that it matches the vocals. Yo, this your body, you put in my heart for lockdown, oh lockdown. All right, this, I don't know, I can't tell whether it's on beat or not. Banga, baby, calm down, calm down. I think that might be on beat. Let's change the pitch so that it doesn't sound as funny. Let's look up the keys. All right, so Love Non Tinti is A flat major and Calm Down Selena Gomez key. Let's see. Tune Batch really good for this. It's in B major. So how many semitones? Semitones between keys. Between B major and A flat major, I think there are 3 semitones. I actually cheated and used Fadr for that. But I'm sure someone with more music theory knowledge would be able to figure that one out. So let's pitch this up 3 semitones. And see how it sounds. Another banga, baby, calm down, calm down. Now let's try to get them a little more sound. Another banga, baby, calm down, calm down. Yo, this your body, you put in my heart for lockdown. I think the instrumental has to get a little quieter here. Let's try -6. Another banga, baby, calm down, calm down. Yo, this your body, you put in my heart for lockdown, for lockdown, oh lockdown. Yo, you sweet life, Fanta, Fanta. If I tell you, say I love you, no day for me, hang out. Let's see. I'm not sure. Let's try aligning it like so. I can tell it's beat aligned, but it's just like, the beats are a little bit off. Let's try dragging it like so. I'm just gonna set the in and out to here. Another banga, baby, calm down, calm down. Yo, this your body, he puts in my heart for lockdown. Alright guys, that's pretty good. Let's give it a listen. Another banga, baby, calm down, calm down. Yo, this your body, he puts in my heart for lockdown, for lockdown, oh lockdown. Yo, you sweet life, Fanta,
for town. If I tell you say I love you, you know they for me young out. Oh young girl, no tell me no 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 no. Oh 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 oh. Baby gone.
Alright, I'm not gonna lie, that actually went quite a bit faster than I expected it to. But let's see how long it takes me to do with Fadr. Okay. Alright, let's see, okay? Remix. My stems. Let's add Selena Gomez vocals. CK instrumental. Let's give it a listen.
Oh, lockdown. Girl, you sweet like Fanta. Fanta. If I tell you say I love you, you know they for me young girl. Oh, young girl. No, tell me no, 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 no. Oh, 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 oh. Baby, gon' give me.
Alright, let's export it. Alright, guys. I mean, the comparison is night and day, okay? Like, what, maybe it took 15 seconds? And then you get all this additional information here. This is how I figured out it was three semitones earlier, is because we got B flat major, which you can see here. CK is in A flat major. And then the Selena Gomez song is in B major, so it's just, you know, it was one, two, three. So that's how I decided the three semitones. But like I said, somebody with more music theory knowledge probably could have figured that one out. But yeah, honestly, I'm a little surprised at how much time it took me on Ableton. It actually wasn't as difficult as I thought, but, you know, if you're just trying to experiment, like you're trying to figure out two songs that are going to work together on Ableton, even if you're really good at it and it's taking you like 3 or 4 minutes to get it beat aligned, get the tempos, get the keys, decide how many semitones to pitch. I mean, you know, do you really want to spend 3 minutes on each experiment, or do you just want to use Fadr and, you know, pump out a bunch of mashups, 15 seconds a piece, and find out whether it works or not? Okay, you might be like, well, what good is Fadr if I can't add my own samples, if I can't add my own touch, I want to use my own plugins from my DAW, etc., etc. Well, if you have a premium subscription, what you can do is you can actually download the tracks. So after you export, you can download the tracks here, and they're already going to have their modifications here. So after I download, this is going to be pitch shifted using the AI algorithms, tempo shifted using AI algorithms, and I can just drop these into Ableton, and then I can add my own touch. So I can just download all my remix tracks. And then, if I want, I can just take it all over to the DAW.
So, hopefully, after watching this video, you guys got a decent understanding of what Fadr can do for you. And you understand that Fadr is just a tool in your arsenal. Obviously, making the mashup in Fadr was way quicker than it was on Ableton. But, you know, if you want to add your own touches to it, Ableton's a place to be. So, being able to use the parts of Fadr to synchronize your mashup quickly in pitch and tempo, and then exporting it all over to Ableton, is probably your best bet if you're just looking for the fastest workflow. And then, if you're just looking to experiment, obviously, Fadr's gonna be way quicker and way less labor-intensive compared to having to, you know, drag around and beat synchronize. Then, obviously, Fadr is just way less labor intensive. So if you're just looking to experiment, you know, 15 second little experiment in Fadr saves you 5 minutes of figuring out what keys the songs are in, how many semitones are between them, the tempos, then beat alignment. Yeah, Ableton doesn't take that long, but you know, if you're gonna be cranking out mashups, or you're just experimenting and you have to go through 10 different songs until you find the ones that mash up together, Fadr is gonna be the place to be. So if you haven't already, guys, please subscribe to the video, hit the thumbs up button, leave a comment down below. I'll be watching and I'm gonna try to reply to any questions that you might have. So thank you.